job, and I'm sure the award is waiting in the wings somewhere. All right, with that, we're going to go to item number 13, which is consideration of taking a position in support. I'm sorry. We're going to item 12, which is consideration of support for the Transportation Authority of Marin in their effort to remove a state procedural obstacle to allow a community conversation and maximum flexibility for local jurisdiction. I'm going to look to our city manager, Rita Candelario, who will be presenting and introducing.
Thank you, Mayor Addison, council members. This item is being brought before you tonight by staff at the request of one of our other governmental agencies in the county. And the first thing I want to share is that actually a little bit of an apology for the length of the subject item. It is quite lengthy and wordy, and I apologize for that. I really should have spent more time on that particular aspect of this item and made it more clear for the council and for the community. I've actually received lots of calls and comments and emails, and the council members may have also received some comments regarding that aspect of this agenda item, so I do apologize for that. There's also been some confusion in the community regarding the actions we're actually going to be taking tonight, if any. So I'm hoping that as we move through the verbal presentation, it will be cleared up and we'll be able to get through that tonight. But I mentioned we do have a couple of guest speakers, from PAM, our Transportation Authority in Marin, which is the organization that asked for the city council to consider this item. I understand that they've made similar requests to all the other municipalities of the other cities in our county of Marin, and that's why we put the item on tonight's agenda for the council here. So I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to the staff from PAM, who have some information they'd like to share over this item with the council.
Thank you, Mr. City Manager. Good evening, Madam Mayor and council members. And I want to say good evening to the public, too. I apologize my back is to you, but I'll be talking to you as well tonight. A shout out to Mill Valley and Susan Kirsch, who's here. And Claudia, welcome to Novato. Novato's name is Tam Valley's Law. She was very loved down there.
And if you could just state who you are for the record.
I better do that. I'm Stephanie Holton Peters, the chair of the Transportation Authority of Marin Board and a city council member from Mill Valley. I also want to introduce Diane Steinhauser, the executive director of the Transportation Authority of Marin, and Molly Graham, our public outreach coordinator, who's also here tonight.
Welcome to you all. Thanks very much for coming.
Thank you for having us. I know you've had a full agenda. I want to take just a little time to introduce TAM for those of you who may not know TAM and what we do and the need that we address at the Transportation Authority. You can go to the first slide. We are a local sales tax authority and a congestion management agency. In 2004, we passed a local sales tax, Measure A, a half-cent sales tax, which generates local funds, which fund transportation projects, and is also used to leverage federal and state grant funding. Let's go back to that slide for just a moment, if I might. If you look at the purple segment of this slide, you will see that in Marin County, a full 72% of funds spent on transportation come from a local source, our Measure A. 8% in the light blue comes from federal, 5% from the state, and regional bridge toll funding and other grants constitutes 15%. Now, I will tell you, it didn't used to be this way, and we actually formally got more money from the federal and state government level. But those funding levels have dropped off over time, which makes our local funding more and more important. So that's our backdrop. Next slide, please. In our local Measure A sales tax that exists right now, the breakdown of what we fund is this. 55% goes to local bus transit. When Measure A was passed in 2004, there was a severe cutback in local bus funding. And we would not have the bus service we have today if we did not have this local funding. So that you can see is the largest chunk. Beyond that, the red HOV gap closure, that was the Terra Linda, Porter Swallow Hill carpool lane that was finished several years ago, completing that gap. Local streets and roads receives 26.5% of the Measure A funding. That's for all the streets and roads in the county and the cities and towns of Berlin. And then 11% go to school safety and access. This includes our Safe Routes to School program, our Safe Pathways grants, and all those things that crossing guards as well. Next slide, please. So just a little deeper dive into that. Nearly 80% of the existing Measure A goes to transit, which I've described, and safe routes, and to local road maintenance. Another roughly 20% goes to capital projects, major roads like your Nevada Boulevard, and formerly that gap closure project. So most of our money is spoken for with recurring needs, maintenance, transit, safe routes. A smaller proportion is available for capital projects. Those capital projects also receive funding from the state and federal government, but I wanted you to understand sort of what TAM pays for in the current sales tax measure. Next slide, let's look at some key Novato projects that have been funded to date by Measure A. Local road funding, you've received over $5 million to date to maintain your roads. There's a list, they're superimposed on the slide, but this comes out of your streets and road maintenance list. There is roughly 5.7 or 8 million additional funding we project that Novato will receive through the end of our 2024-25 term for this tax measure. A separate category is major roads, and these are the major arterials in Marin County that were identified in a public process and prioritized for road major rehab. So Novato was right up there in receiving $12.179 million has been programmed for Novato Boulevard. An additional $1.7 million has been allocated for phase one. Just briefly, as I mentioned, our Safe Routes to School program, Novato has received funding for Plum Street and Hill Middle School improvements, $600,000, another $25,000 for crosswalk enhancement projects. You have 11 schools participating in Safe Routes. At a request from the former Novato council member, Madeline Kellner, we met the need for bilingual safety education for schools in Novato and San Rafael in Safe Routes. That was good. You have 20 crossing guards, 16 are paid for by TAM, and then 4 by your school district, and 17 infrastructure projects to improve safety around schools. So that is what's been done. In addition, we have transit funded by Measure A at the locations listed on this slide in Novato. We provide service to all the high schools and the middle schools in Novato. We have about 560 school students a day. We service the Hamilton and Ignacio South Novato Boulevard, Vintage Oaks, and College of Marin. And we have allocated some $5.7 million for various bus stop improvements in Novato via Marin Transit. So, let me just say, we're here at the very beginning of contemplating renewing our sales tax. It's not too early for us to begin to think about this. We know that passing sales taxes with a two-thirds majority, which is what's required, is a big project. And it takes work to develop an expenditure plan that the community backs, and with significant public participation from the community. And these, again, require two-thirds vote. And we're beginning this discussion right now. We hope to go to the ballot in 2018. For some reason, should it not pass, we'll have time to regroup and come again in 2020, or God forbid, 2024, which is cutting it awfully close. We do need, at a minimum, to renew this sales tax for the reasons that you've seen, just to stay even with where we are. Now, I don't know about you, but I get a lot of requests in my city for more transportation funding, more pothole repair. We don't have new on-ramps to 101 like you guys do. We have old, out-of-date ones in Mill Valley. We'd like to get those modernized so they carry the amount of traffic that yours do. I'm sure you have requests, school bus service, more roads and sidewalks. This is the reason we're here tonight, to come before you with a administrative matter that would be carried by our state legislator, so that we can have a conversation about, are there other needs we might like to fund in the renewal of the sales tax? We did some polling in 2014 to gauge public interest and willingness to fund a little bit more in sales tax for transportation projects. And we were pleasantly surprised to see that with just cold calling, we determined there was nearly 68% voter interest in increasing a sales tax in the future to provide more transportation-related funding. This is without any education, any information. It was just a survey done of the voters, and already we are at 68%. There are things, as I said, like school bus service, senior mobility, more money for streets and roads. I'll be interested to hear during discussion time some of the needs that you see. But this is what is in the background as we contemplate renewing a sales tax. That people like what we're doing, and they like to see more in the way of congestion relief and transportation services. Next slide, please. So, that gets us to our discussion at hand for tonight. We are here to ask for your support for TAM, seeking legislation of an administrative procedural nature that would allow the raising or exemption of the sales tax cap. I'll go into all of that in just a moment. What is that? What I want to say clearly to you, the council, and also to the community, we're not asking
for the council. Stephanie, if you won't speak to the council.
I'm sorry. We're not asking the council to approve a sales tax increase tonight. We're not at all. So I just wanted to make that clear. That any effort to increase our sales tax for transportation would come down the road next year after we've put a sales tax expenditure plan together, and I'll go through that in detail. That will come to your council for approval. It will also finally go to the public for a vote before any change in the sales tax is made. So tonight is not a vote about increasing the sales tax cap. Let me go on now. What is the sales tax cap? Under current state law, the state can levy up to 7.5% at the top of this slide in taxes for statewide issues and projects. Beyond that, local governments are allowed to levy up to 2% more in local sales taxes to fund local projects and programs. This is a list of the cumulative total state plus local sales taxes that have been levied by the different cities and towns in Marin County. Novato is there about two-thirds of the way down at 8.50%. Let's go to the next slide. This is what I call my headroom slide. If the current cap is at the red line at 9.25%, state and local cumulative, local governments have the discretion to utilize whatever is under the red line for your local purposes. There are some cities like Santa Fe and Fairfax that are bumping up very close to the top at 9%. They have a quarter cent left in taxing ability for local government projects. TAM does not want to preclude those cities or Novato from utilizing the remainder of that area up to the red line. That is your money, your local control, and your use for things you feel are important. Next, so this is why we are talking with Senator McGuire to carry legislation that would allow an exemption to the cap at the red line up to a 0.5% additional beyond the cap specifically for transportation purposes. Next slide, please. The governor has approved sales tax caps increases specifically for transportation needs for Alameda County, for Monterey County, for Contra Costa. They have all approached the governor for a special exemption for this purpose. He's willing to do that. He is not willing to raise the cap for general purposes. It really is just transportation because the need for funding is so great. Next slide, please. So this process, we have a legislative process that we are here before you tonight, and a separate sales tax expenditure plan development process that is starting this year. The two processes will come together down the road next year. The legislative season is starting this year. This is the time bills get introduced. This is why we're here before you tonight for support for introducing legislation that will allow an exemption to the sales cap, that will allow us to have a conversation about what we want to fund in the future. Step two, we're starting a whole conversation this month. Councilmember Lucan is part of a TAM steering committee that will guide an expenditure plan process. There will be an expenditure plan committee full of stakeholders, community members, a little later this year to begin to flesh out what would a renewed sales tax look like, what do we want in it, and what do we think voters are willing to support. We'll come to your community, we'll come to all of our own communities to get input. That plan will come to you next year for approval, and then would go to voters if approved. So, I think it's getting late and I'm slowing down. I apologize, and I'm trying to pick it up and wrap it up. I think I've covered this now, that we've got a legislative process here, an expenditure plan process here. We're going to meet in the middle in several months, and there will be a large public element, engagement element to this whole thing. Next slide, please. So I'm going to wrap up and then welcome your question. Our request tonight is that you consider supporting TAM's request to the legislature for a exemption to the current sales tax cap for transportation purposes of up to a 0.5 cent. It doesn't mean we will actually decide on a 0.5 cent. That will be decided after the expenditure plan process. But this allows us to even begin to have a conversation about this. If we don't do this, we're pretty much stuck with what we have. And what we have in the current sales tax is great, but the need is also great. Senator McGuire is our likely sponsor, and with that, I'll close and call for questions.
Thank you very much, Stephanie, for the report. I'm going to go to council for two questions each, and then I'm going to go to the public. I'll come back to council for more questions. I'm going to start with the person who serves on the committee, Councilmember Lucan.
Great. Stephanie, so great to see you here in Novato. Just two quick questions. I got a lot of emails today. I think Novato's got a lot of emails today over the past couple days. Your presentation answered, I think, almost all of the questions that came up. There was one that I'd ask you to clarify for the public. If Measure A does not expire till 2024, but we are able to renew it in 2018, a lot of emails that got up, there was going to be a duplicate tax, so they'd be paying it twice. Can you just, for the record, clarify what happens when a tax is renewed before an expiration date and how that plays out?
Great. I can do that, but I think I'm going to hand it off to our executive director.
Okay.
Thank you. I'm Diane Steinhauser, executive director with TM. The renewal of the sales tax would be from the point at which we cease to collect it, which is March 31st of 2025, for another X years, and we would have to determine what that is. Often it's 10, 20, 30 years. That would be part of the discussion we would have. There would not be a duplicate tax in the case of the renewal.
Right.
It would be a continuation.
Thanks for clarifying that on the record. Second question, probably for you, Diane. If we just renew at a half cent, what are the possibilities of that half cent having a meaningful impact in reducing congestion beyond what we have today for the thousands of people that sit in gridlock on a daily basis?
Well, that's, I will offer an opinion. This is what the tax currently pays for. We've seen progress with respect to conversion to more non-vehicular trips. To maintain what we've achieved, we need to continue the investments in these currently operated programs. But as I came to you last week and spoke about the Marin-Sonoma Narrows, as we're facing very strong congestion in the southern areas of the county, what Stephanie mentioned as her interchange at Tiburani's Bike Hill with 101, again, there is a tiny bit of money that's freed up in a renewal process. But unlike many other sales tax programs around the state, we have the majority of our funds in ongoing programs that we need to maintain so we don't lose ground and actually cause more congestion. We're very proud of our Safe Routes program, for example, which has, in the 2011 to 2015 period, been able to land on a 50% green trip distribution at the schools. We need to keep that up. So the continuation of the existing program, I think, will keep us from losing ground. But those new things that we talked about, school bus service, interchange improvements, the narrows, more options for seniors, pedestrian improvements that don't get addressed. All of those could be the subject. And we've learned from our polling are a good starting point for considering some kind of additional revenue.
Thank you.
I'm going to go to Councilmember Drew.
First question. Is the presentation tonight identical to the presentation that you gave the San Rafael Council earlier this week?
It is been moved around a little bit. The slides were reordered, Pam, and they were put by me in layman's terms. And that is why Diane is standing here, to give you the deeper dive if you need it. It is the same material covered, but we decided to start the presentation with the top level, the major concepts, and then let you ask questions. But the same points have been covered.
I appreciate that, and I ask identical because it seems to me that the titling that Regan Candelario referred to first in this presentation is a really immediate concern. We don't have the seats full. We are here at 10, 15. There are many people who have no idea what removing a state procedural obstacle is. We have probably thousands, the same number of people that are idling on freeways and traffic is the same number of people who don't recognize a sales cap exemption, whenever it's called a state procedural obstacle. They don't understand either that you're having a community conversation. They think that you are taking the first step towards going for a sales tax increase.
Can I ask a question, please?
Conversation and then left maximum flexibility for local jurisdictions to pay the cost of things like the Novato Narrows that the federal government and the state government has traditionally covered. So if you look behind you, we don't have the people of Novato here, and they haven't had a chance to understand what this item is all about. So the question was, why did you change the titling of the item?
This is the title we used. We've used this title for the two previous presentations, which is this discussion opportunity framework for addressing our transportation needs.
This is a different title than was in the San Rafael agenda. A completely different title.
Yeah.
It was very straightforward.
I understand as a fellow council member that the importance of clarity and transparency. And I apologize sincerely if this does not look as transparent as you might have liked. I can tell you that this is an administrative step in a process which has many checks and balances along the way, where the community will have an opportunity, thumbs up and thumbs down, and you as a council member and your colleagues will have opportunities, thumbs up and thumbs down. We are not asking to raise the sales tax tonight.
Pam, do you have another question?
My other question is...
If you could speak into the mic.
My other question is, why shouldn't we just simply re-agendize this matter? Because our people are not here. They haven't had the opportunity to know to be here. And you're talking to... there are limited number of folks, and our whole point of existence is to get the message to the people, and certainly on anything like the sales cap exemption. So, shall we just put this off?
I would certainly defer to you and your colleagues. I respect that decision.
Thank you.
I'm going to go to Mayor Pro Tem Friday.
Thank you, and thank you both for the presentation. My first question, I think, is on page numbers. The Key Novato Projects funded by Measure A. So it talks about local roads funding, how much money has come to Novato as a result of Measure A. There's $5 million so far received to date, an additional $5.7 million. I guess I'm curious as to what, if there's also a breakdown of what the contribution is by Novato to sort of the overall fund. In other words, obviously there's all the money goes into a big pot and then it gets distributed. So if we're getting $5 million, how much are we putting in? Are we getting back dollar for dollar, more or less? Is that information available?
What we have learned from the Board of Equalization is that they can present data to us from the major contributors around Marin County in alphabetical order. So we don't have that slide here this evening, but we can easily provide who are the top 30 contributors to sales tax business entities primarily in Marin. We get that update from them every year. They do not provide a breakdown by jurisdiction. They provide only an alphabetical listing of the top 30 contributors to the sales tax fund. That's the information that we have. There are very strict requirements on how they display and report information regarding sales tax.
So that information, not, we just don't have that.
We don't have that.
And then my second question, I guess, I do have more questions, but we'll get to it later. Is, Jeff, this is for you. And Regan, I do appreciate you addressing the clarity issue with regard to the title. Like everyone, I received many emails about this issue. My interpretation of a lot of the confusion that took place was actually a result of direct false information being distributed to members of our community about what decision is actually happening tonight and what decision in the process we're going through. So Jeff, my question to you is, can the Nevada City Council raise sales taxes to go towards TAM?
The council cannot on its own adopt sales taxes.
Can the Nevada City Council have decided to lower sales taxes that goes to TAM?
No.
So who does decide ultimately what sales taxes, whether they're raised or lowered, kept the same, goes to TAM or doesn't go to TAM?
People.
I'm going to go to Councilmember Eflin.
Yes, I'm going to follow up on Councilmember Drew's question. The title that's on the agenda packet, did TAM create that title? That was on the staff report.
We were asked by the city managers around Marin to provide supporting documentation. So we provided a series of documents on what exactly our proposal was. Each city manager derived a staff report from a series of documents that we sent them.
Okay.
So that's how the process
is. So it sounds like you wrote the staff report. I want to ask, Regan Candelario, our city manager, did you change the subject title at all on the staff report from what the Transportation Authority gave you?
I did not.
Thank you. The other question I have is that I haven't heard of a jurisdiction or a JPA looking to extend a sales tax 8 years before it expires. Why is the Transportation Authority Marin pursuing this route 8 years before the tax expires?
I can think of two examples offhand. Would be glad to provide further information to the council. Contra Costa extended their sales tax in 2012, 8 years before the expiration date. Santa Clara also extended the sales tax, I'm going to get the year wrong, 8 years. And it could have been 6 years prior to the expiration date. It is a common practice. It is most often done with respect to the continuation of revenue that could then be advanced in a bond scenario in order to build projects. And that was the purpose that both of those counties extended substantially earlier than the expiration date. And we'd be glad there's 24 counties statewide that have sales taxes, we'd be glad to provide additional information on those renewal metrics.
Thank you. The other question I have is on your slide that says provide an opportunity. It's slide number 9, there is page numbers. It says the amount of an augmented sales tax has yet to be determined. The amount of an augmented sales tax has yet to be determined.
Yes.
So it sounds as though that there is already an assumption that the sales tax is going to be augmented, but the issue is how much it's going to be augmented.
So Councilmember Eklund, point well made. Flying back here on the plane this afternoon from Los Angeles, I read these slides and I had the same thought. That frankly, augmented should be deleted. We do not know at this point in time and we do not have any information other than the poll and what we hear to make that statement. So I think it would be more realistic to say the amount of a sales tax has yet to be determined.
The last question I have is, when community members get together and identify what they would like to see in terms of projects completed, with the current amount of the tax, people really look carefully at how the funds were expended and really determine their priorities. Whereas if you have these community meetings with the sales tax rate allowing for an augmented sales tax, people have a different perspective in looking at what their needs are. They look at expanding their expenditures for what they're doing today. So why hasn't TAM taken the time now to really do community outreach to find out whether or not people agree with the current expenditure allocations and whether or not the needs are greater than what we're currently doing? Because I'll ask that.
Yeah, that's a great question. We will absolutely be asking those questions as we go forward with the expenditure plan process. I will be candid that the legislative calendar that overlays this is out of sync with the process from a, how would you do this standpoint? Maybe that's too heavy-handed to say. We do need to go through this conversation. We will ask those questions. We will come out the other end, because the worst thing that could happen, I'm sure you'll agree, is if we developed an expenditure plan that there was not public support for. We absolutely need to renew the sales tax, at least at the current level. We need to have the voters with us, so we need to be very, very careful throughout this whole process in determining what the needs are and the priorities and the funding available. So no disagreement about that whole conversation has to take place.
Yeah,
we're going to come back for round seven after that, and I have some questions as well. My two questions, and before I get to my questions, if I can just do some little administration here. What is that? That's a
3-2.
3-2. All right, so with that, I apologize again. We're going to go back on this item. Thank you all for your patience in going through that painful experience. So please, as Stephanie did with that. So I would believe I was asking my questions at this point. I just wanted to get a verification on the page number 12, where you talked about the different percentages of taxes that's in each of the cities. And I wanted to know, I know that the state tax just sunsetted, one of the retail taxes from the state just sunsetted, and I wanted to know if these are reflective of that sunset.
Yeah, this is the effective tax rates as of January 1st, 2017.
Okay.
So the state tax rate had been 7.5%. Prop 55 lowered that to 7.25.
Okay.
So these are the current rates effective this month.
Okay, good. And then for clarification purposes, let's say we didn't support this evening, and we didn't. Is there anything that would prohibit TAM, but if you didn't get that cap from us tonight, if we said we didn't want you to go to the legislature and have the cap above, is there anything that would prohibit you from continuing to put this on the ballot, but then it would affect the bar, I mean, if you could put up the slide where you're looking at that bar, yeah, that one. It's my understanding by what you were talking about that if we didn't do anything tonight, if we took no action on it or whatever opposed, is it my understanding that TAM could still try and get this on the ballot, but then it would affect everything below the red bar?
So you're asking if we could, if TAM could take that last quarter percent available. In theory, we could. We don't want to do that because we don't want to take away local control and the local right to it. So this is why we are advocating for a sales tax cap exemption to let the cities have whatever the remainder is that is available to them.
So if you had the right, just to follow up to that, if you had the right to do that, we actually are losing local control.
That is correct.
By not letting this conversation happen and, you know, over this next, what sounds like at least a year of conversation with the public, it could injure us in the process.
Yes, it could. It is most sensitive for the cities of San Rafael and Fairfax, which are right up against it. San Rafael is considering some issues of their own. So there are cities that would lose if TAM eclipsed them and utilized that last quarter percent. We don't want to do that. We respect the city's local control rights. As a fellow council member, I wouldn't feel right about eclipsing cities' local control.
Okay. And my question before we go to the public again is does exempting the cap mean, are we giving permission to the state or any other districts to come past that cap? I mean, is it just merely for TAM, or does it open up an agenda then where this cap has been released and anybody can come in and put something on the ballot and God knows where the taxes end up for our constituents?
Excellent question. This sales tax cap exemption is specifically for TAM, for transportation projects only. It is not for any other use, and it does not open the gate. There is a ceiling of a half cent we're requesting. It doesn't mean we'll use any or all of it, but it is not for any other purpose other than transportation. The governor will not approve those.
Okay, thank you very much. I'm gonna go to the public and come back to council for more questions. So my first card is for Al Dugan. Thank you all for waiting.
Yeah, it's the Baton Death March here. I've gotta touch once more on the agenda and the title of the agenda, because, you know, there's not one mention of taxes in that agenda title. And I really have a problem with calling a sales tax cap an obstruction. So I think that the city council, the city staff should have made a change to that to make it more accurate for the city. I hope you do not support raising the sales tax cap. I believe it must be objected. That cap was put in place due to the never-ending quest by state and local governments for more funds from the city. The cap reflects a government budget. They need to live with it. Now, I find it interesting, Councilman Friday, or Mayor Pro Tem Friday, mentioned that a third of the people in Nevada made $30,000 or less. This is a super regressive tax.
That is not what I said, just for clarification.
Okay, what was it? How many people?
A third of the students in Nevada are eligible for free lunch.
Okay, a third of the people. So that means...
No.
A third of the students.
Let's be clear about the facts.
Right.
A third of the students in Nevada are eligible for free lunch.
Okay, So this is a regressive tax, and for people on low income, it takes money right out of their pocket every day. TAM has Measure A, and it doesn't expire until 2025. The TAM record with taxpayers' dollars is terrible. Their work on the Redwood grant, they picked a center platform that ended up without proper engineering, without proper traffic studies, and it's ballooned in engineering costs, and it's been a poor job. They spent $1.4 million supplementing that. TAM has no plan for this half-cent tax yet. It's just a blank piece of paper they're presenting to you. And the City Council of San Rafael, where it had actually the word tax in it, voted 4-1 that the future tax grab would be stopped to help the citizens and to make sure that future taxes aren't added and don't breach the firewall. So I ask you to please represent the citizens of Novato and reject it.
I'm David McLaughlin, followed by Tony Schroeder.
Hi, I'm David McLaughlin. Thanks for keeping me up this late. I would say that at this point, and even earlier, if you guys were showing any real leadership, you would have tabled this meeting to another time, because you have sorely and inadequately notified the public of any tax measure being discussed tonight. So I don't think you're on legitimate ground anywhere, okay? And I think if you show a little gumption, it's, you know, gonna be midnight when we get out of here. If you show a little gumption and a little leadership, we citizens would appreciate it, you know? We don't appreciate it being put up as the last agenda item for the night. That was bad enough, that's by design. We don't appreciate the transparency. You guys have been working on transparency for the last 2 years, and this comes and you have no filter. You just rubber stamp whatever they want to give you and say, sounds good to me. We don't need to say tax, even though we're discussing the tax. Yeah, it's an obstacle to the state or to TAM that wants to spend money. It's an obstacle to their spending money. You know, and as far as where the money's going to go, what did your Governor Brown say in 2012? We passed Proposition 30, and that was going to go help all the schools. You know how much money went to the classroom? Zero. It went to pensions. You have pension problems, you don't address them, they get worse, you ask for more taxes. The public's tired of it, very tired of it. What else do you do? Fiscal responsibility. You know, Governor also that has just found a $1.6 billion inadequacy in his budget, a shortfall in the budget. It wasn't brought forward until it's time to review the budget, even though it was well known. You have a governor that wants to spend $5 billion on a fast train nowhere, and you've got the local train station to nowhere that costs you $5 million. So your fiscal irresponsibility is showing. You give money to the theater, you give money to a train station that you don't have, you put out a brochure on Measure C that absolutely lies to the public and calls it a decrease in taxes. You guys could be ashamed of yourself. So anyway, I'd like to ask you to show a little gumption, go against your proclivities, and shelve this meeting to a future date, okay, when we can have proper notification. Thank you.
Thank you. Tony Schroeder, followed by Doug Kelly.
I was going to say good evening, but I think I should say good night. It's getting quite late. I'm Tony Schroeder, Novato resident and a taxpayer. I want to thank you, Pam Drew, for calling out TAM, what we would call in the private sector, a bait and switch presentation, something that was different than the San Rafael presentation, which was asked for. We clearly do not have a transparent government as seen with TAM, as well as their presentation, as well as the agenda that was on tonight. The tax increase called an obstacle. This is a tax, it's not an obstacle. That's shameful that the Novato city manager allowed that to happen. I'm cognizant he gave an apology, but that's just simply not right. The good people of Novato are entitled to transparency and from our government, and we simply are not getting it. I'm asking you to support the good people of Novato and not endorse this tax cap increase. Enough is enough, but TAM just wants more. The good people of Novato and Marin County are being financially assaulted everywhere they turn. There seems to be no end in sight for the incessant tax increases. As a real estate professional, and Denise, you have probably seen this as well, I'm seeing people leave Marin County, and specifically Novato, simply because they are being taxed out. These terrific people are our seniors, our coaches, our neighbors, our friends, and small business owners. They are just getting squeezed and squeezed. We are not rich here in Novato, and we keep paying more and more taxes. TAM has not been transparent, they've been incompetent, and they have not been fiscally responsible. And they have not, if you've been paying attention, you would see this, Eric, as being on their board, they have not been good stewards of our hardworking public funds, and that's another conversation. We see empty buses going round and round. I think before they ask us for more money, they should be more efficient. And if you do endorse this proposal of the tax increase and say, oh, let the voters decide, TAM will waste a lot more taxpayer money hiring consultants after consultants, paying Sacramento lobbyists, and then the opponents that try to push back against this will be bullied repeatedly and demonized by the establishment. So Pam, Josh, Denise, Eric, and Pat, I'm asking you to say a thumbs down to TAM for this tax increase. Thank you.
Thanks, Tony. Doug Kelly, followed by Susan Hirsch.
Thanks very much, Madam Mayor, Council members. A couple of things on the title of the measure. I'm going to be very clear. I represent myself exclusively here tonight, but I just wear a couple of hats. I'm a business owner in San Rafael. All of my customers all over the county are affected by taxes. So I have clients all over the state, in fact, all over the country, but in particular in Marin County, may be affected by this. I also serve as the vice chair of the San Anselmo Chamber of Commerce. Again, I'm not speaking on their behalf. We haven't met on this measure, so I couldn't talk about it. But I did call the president of the Nevada Chamber of Commerce, Coy Smith. No, I've never met him before, but he said, yeah, I'm going to the meeting this evening because there's a couple of awards at the beginning, but then I'm leaving because there's no measure on taxes on the Nevada agenda, which I'm holding in my hand. So if the president of the Novato Chamber of Commerce is not aware of this, then the rest of your citizens aren't either. I'm a lifelong Democrat, and I'm proud of my party, and I love my party. I'm not proud of the statement by the Speaker of the House of Representatives where she said we needed to pass a bill to find out what was in the bill. This is actually a little worse than that, because there is no bill here. And while I have great respect for everyone who serves on TAM, and I have respect for TAM, we need to see the bill. Anytime you increase taxes or you increase the cap so that you can increase taxes, you're squeezing out other needs. And regardless of where the cap goes, you're going to lose local control because any increase in one end of the bubble is going to push and put pressure on the other end. I'd like to remind this council that the 60-some-odd percent that might favor such a tax were asked about a one-quarter tax, not a half tax. So that's just to clarify that. And the other thing is just to keep in mind that caps in general and tax caps aren't put on jars by mistake. Caps are put on jars so you don't get covered in a mess. At some point, we're going to really squeeze out the young and the elderly, which is something that was brought up right here on this council earlier this evening. So we do agree with the need to improve safety in roads, But we also, I think, will see a statewide increase, possibly in the gas tax, and we may see an increase in the vehicle tax, and I think it's appropriate for us to wait for that. While I agree with Stephanie Moulton Peters that she was looking at...
If you could wrap it up.
Yeah, the headroom, I think we also need to look a little bit about the wallet room, and I think the wallet room's getting a little filled up. Thank you
very much. Susan Kirsch, followed by Tina McMillan.
Good evening. Thank you for having us on the agenda. Stephanie, thank you for a great presentation. I think it's a little bizarre that we would think there has to be legislative action to be able to open a conversation. And this whole thing seems to be about whether there would be a conversation around what the needs are in transportation. And to have this then becoming an issue around a legislative action just seems very peculiar. And it seems like it is getting the cart before the horse to think that we're even going through this whole ordeal, and that many of us are feeling a need to be more thoughtful about taxes, being a part of the group called the Coalition for Sensible Taxation, or costs, but appreciate the chance to bring this forward. The whole issue of transparency just seems to be so crucial in this whole measure, and the fact that it's TAM who gave the city manager this title of looking at removing a state procedural obstacle. And to echo what Doug Kelly said, I was thinking of a tax cap in the form of caps that keep our heads warm or give us protection, as in wearing hats, that this cap is intended to protect the public. So again, I would encourage you to deny this resolution, to support the protective quality of a tax cap, and to know that we have 8 years before there is really urgency about this, and there'll be plenty of time to bring the measure forward before we hit 8 years from now. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Tina McMillan, followed by Trish Borstein.
Thank you all for standing up so late. While I agree with Pam on it gets difficult for us after a while as we get a little bit older, I still appreciate you all being here. When I read about this, I was also put off by the way that things were phrased, just because I live in Novato and I am acutely aware that in Novato we live modestly. We are not Southern Marin. We're folks who have to live within our means. And some of my frustration with not the fact that TAM doesn't do good work for good reasons, but I don't believe TAM lives within its means. And so when I read the term procedural obstacle, the way I looked at it was the cap on transit tax is more than just a procedural obstacle. It's a protection under the law for taxpayers who are already stretched thin by sales tax that will soon reach 10%. When I went back and I looked at Measure A, I wanted to understand what kind of budget TAM expected to be living with beginning in 2004. And what I found was that they expected revenue of approximately $16.5 million a year. But every single year that Measure A has been in place, it's created more revenue than that. It was close to 20 the first year, and in 2014-15, which is the latest data from their Citizen Oversight Committee, it was over $25 million. So TAM hasn't just gotten a good deal by the tax that was voted in 2004. They've gotten incredibly more revenue than they expected. So then I asked myself, because I've been reading about potential vehicle mileage tax, increases to gas tax, it's because it's not just TAM, it's MTC, it's the Bridge District, and it's the state. And I looked up Senator McGuire, and I realized he had co-authored a bill that may be coming back through. It's a little confusing. I'm not used to reading this stuff. But the bill is very specific. The bill is going to increase the gas tax by approximately 17 cents a gallon. It's going to provide upwards of $200 million a year. And the $200 million is going to go towards road maintenance and rehabilitation. Out of that $200 million, there are different categories, but ultimately the most important category is maintenance of cities and county roads. So we've got
$0.17 a gallon increase to gas tax, $38 increase to registration fee plus inflation adjustment, $165 annual vehicle registration fee for zero emission vehicles.
If you could wrap up, please.
I will. My point is, what you hold in your hands isn't a duty to TAM to make it easier for them to sponsor legislation. It's a duty to the residents of Novato to slow them down and make them thoughtful and help them learn to live within their means.
Thank you, Dean. Trish Forstein, followed by Amy Willard, and the last card I have is for Stephen Nessel.
Good evening, everyone. Trish Forstein, Novato. First of all, I think 8 years is a lengthy period of time before Measure A runs out, and I really don't see why transparency should be up foremost in the front for this discussion to happen with the community from TAM. And I really think that we need to polish our eyeglasses to make sure we're reading and seeing what we're putting on our agendas, because if COI didn't know that there was a tax even being discussed tonight, honestly, it just seems very unclear. And I would also like to know how many of the people that have communicated with all of you regarding this item are asking you to endorse it. That would be of interest to you. So please consider not endorsing this evening and just bring this around and really make this a priority to present it to your people. 8 years is a long time. We have plenty of time, and even a legislation schedule shouldn't have to push this through. Thank you.
And Mimi Willard?
Good evening. I just start by saying I feel kind of sorry for you on City Council in Nevada. I think you'll be a cat. The constituents who have written to you are not confused. TAM is intentionally confusing you. Their story changes. They said that they gave to San Rafael a resolution. It went on their agenda. The resolution was entitled Resolution Supporting Legislation to Exempt the Existing Sales Tax Cap to Accommodate Up to 0.5% for the Transportation Authority of Marin. That's incremental. That is not renewing the existing tax alone. I encourage you to ask them about what they said in San Rafael regarding McGuire's request for unanimity. San Rafael was pushed very hard to endorse, which they declined to do at that moment. They have tabled it indefinitely and seemed to be pretty insistent on staying with indefinitely. But in pressing for their endorsement, they were told that McGuire has told them that he will not move forward unless there's unanimous approval by all 12 jurisdictions. I talked with McGuire's office yesterday, and they see this whole thing as minor. They don't see this moving forward without San Rafael. But I don't want to discourage you from standing up for your taxpayers just because San Rafael's done the bold thing already. So now what's happening is that TAM is pressuring you to endorse quickly and urgently something that was discussed long ago. I certainly saw it in the December 15th TAM commissioners meeting. And at that point, Supervisor Kinsey characterized this as an opportunity to create an opportunity. And tonight, you're also going to probably hear this pitched to you as providing voters a choice or an option. And you will be told that your endorsement is harmless. Well, in fact, endorsing this is the first stage of TAM's plan to seek a sales tax hike that does do harm. First of all, it hurts your constituents. You would be endorsing on their behalf, and you have not been given ample time to consult them because TAM says that they have to get this approved unanimously by the middle of the month.
If you could wrap it up, please.
Okay. I'm looking for the points other people haven't made. Endorsing this measure is contrary to the city of Novato's interest. TAM tells you that this increase won't use up your taxing capacity. That's false. Taxpayers will only say yes so many times.
I'm sorry, your time is up.
TAM gets that first. Novato's request for a tax measure to support its needs may be rejected. So I don't think that supporting this is in the interest of your the constituents. They don't want you to do this, and I'm hoping that you will not.
Thank you, Mimi. Stephen Nessel? Is it Nessel? I'm sorry.
Hi, thank you for allowing me the opportunity to speak. First of all, I'd like to, in particular, thank Mayor Pro Tem Friday for his consideration for the low-income people of the community. Those are my people. I came from a modest circumstance, and I understand the help that they need. But anyhow, I don't live here, but I do shop here. And the reason I shop here is because I can't afford to shop in Southern Marin. If you're a working person, you've got Costco here, you've got Target, you've got Marshalls, you've got all the stores that are affordable for working people. And so instead of heading south, I head north. Now, if you raise tax, obviously that's going to change. But I like paying tax, and I want you to endorse it. And I guess I was one of the ignorant people that you were talking about that didn't understand that you were raising taxes tonight. I know, I guess you're just giving me the opportunity to endorse those taxes. And so on the spur of the moment, I had an inspiration, started a group called Tax Us More. And I hope that each one of you will become charter members of it. But we've got five charter members on the supervisors. We've got five charter members in Fairfax, maybe one charter member in San Rafael. And we'll have a website. We'll make sure that the people know when they have the opportunity to tax us more, that you were the ones that stood by us. Thank you.
Thank you. The last card I have is for Sylvia Berry. If anybody else wishes to speak to this, please fill out a card and give it to me, because it will be coming back to council. Okay. Hi, Sylvia.
Hi. I'm Sylvia Berry, Novato citizen. I actually didn't find out if I was going to have any opinion on that, but I do have some. I just, by listening to the presentation so far, I have some thoughts. First, I was thinking, well, the chart you presented, if San Rafael is going to be the bottleneck and they decided not to go forward, then we actually have more capital, then why do we need to go forward right now? Because we probably don't need to consider it until San Rafael considers it, right? I don't know if I'm right or not. I'm just some thoughts for you, something for you to think about. And secondly, I'm looking at TAM's budget for Novato, the charts they have from 2004 to 2016 right now, 12 years, we have, they allocated about $5.7 million for us to do upgraded roads. However, from 2016 to 2024, 8 years, we have $5+ million, actually more than the last 12 years. 2 years to do the maintenance, so that's in the budget currently, and they have budget for the Novato Boulevard. So that's the second thing. And I know Council Member did kind of ask, do we need to go forward so quickly, you know, 2018 for the 2024 expiration? So it is, we are looking at potentially raising the tax. That's what they're looking at. I think it'll. Last point I have to think about is the fact that I did listen to Diane actually made a few presentations before I heard and asked a question. for their future projects, the bigger projects. Of course, one of the big projects is the Paloma and Novato Mineral widening to finish that. That's one of the big projects. And the other big project is the South of Marine, where they want to add the third lane eastbound to Richmond. And I think those were kind of allow people to come in, use 101 to go to the city or coming out, go to the Richmond East Bay Overlay Hill coming in. And the other big project that you're thinking about citywide is actually the 37, you know, expanding and raising 37, because we saw the flooding, so it's important. But my concern is no matter citizens, and I think council member looking at you as what's in there for us to help us with our transportation.
If you could wrap up.
Okay, so the question is, we have a problem every day from Roland to Smith Ridge, 30 minutes in the morning commute. And when you open up the Novato Railroad and 37, you will have more people get stuck in there. So my question is, are we going to ask Tim, you know, for whatever reason we have more money in there to really consider Novato, because it really is a problem that you know for people from Pinoma to go there.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, seeing nobody else coming to the podium, I'm gonna bring it back to council for more questions. I'm gonna start with Mayor Pro Tem Friday.
Thank you, and thank you for everyone's comments and participation on this issue. Again, I'm very concerned for the community's benefit that we're absolutely clear. The community understands what is being discussed and what is actually the process here, I think it is paramount. And so my question is to our city attorney, as a matter of what we are actually discussing and what is being proposed and what is being asked of the council. Is the city council today, city attorney, Mr. Walter, is the city council considering a tax proposal in this evening's discussion?
No, as I understand it, they're asking for support for legislation to increase the cap on the amount of sales tax that Tim can submit to the voters for approval.
Okay. So again, to be clear to the public, for those watching and those in the audience, the city council is not discussing, we're not considering, we're not debating, we're not deliberating over, we're not doing outreach over a tax proposal. That is not what's happening tonight. Now, and I want our public, and I want our citizens, and I want our people to be very, very clear about that. My second question is, again, to our city attorney, Mr. Walter, did the people of Novato and the people of Marin create the cap that is being discussed tonight on our taxes?
I don't believe so. I believe it was imposed by the state.
So the cap that we're discussing tonight, just to clarify, is a cap that was created by the state of California. And what we're considering tonight is whether we want to give the people of Novato and the people of Marin the option to think about increasing that cap. Is that correct?
The cap would be increased by legislation adopted by the state legislators, not the people of the Marin County or the Nevada.
Okay, so to clarify again, just so if that was confusing for people out there, and if it was confusing, it's my fault.
Okay, he's following up on his question, and I'll move.
To clarify, the cap is state imposed, was not decided by the people of Novato and Marin, and we are asking that the legislature consider, or whether the council wants to support the legislature considering allowing the cap to be raised. Is that correct?
Correct.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Josh. Councilmember Drew.
well, to clarify.
Yeah, if you can speak to the microphone, please.
To clarify here, I'd like to pose a thought experiment. I have a perfectly good Camry. Now I want a new car. I could
call in and fudge a few facts, and I get my credit card limit doubled. Now, I haven't bought the car yet, but instead of having a $10,000 level, I have a $20,000 level now. Now, is this the same as what Tam is asking? Or is this different? Well, this is about the same. They're asking for credit card limit to be increased well in advance. The difference for Tam is that Tam gets the money. Tam gets the car. But in my case, I have to pay back the money that I borrowed for the car. And in Tam's case, all the taxpayers have to pay back the money. Now, Jeff Walter.
Yes?
Is that a reasonable parallel? What do you think? To clarify.
I don't know if it is or not. I know what they're asking, and you can draw analogies as you wish. I suspect there are a number of other comparisons that could be drawn to it.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Do you have another question, Pam?
I think I've asked enough questions.
Okay. I'm going to go to Council Member Eichel.
Yes, I have a question for Guy Steinhauser and Stephanie Moulton-Peters. We heard from the testimony from the speakers tonight that a resolution was brought before the City Council in Severfell, and we don't have such a resolution. So why is different material being distributed to different cities on the same subject matter? Certainly, each city is going forward in handling this matter as they wish. The City of Fairfax action was to direct the city manager to send a letter of support to TAM. It was not a resolution.
But did you supply the resolution to the town of Fairfax? So how come Centerville had a resolution?
We did not supply a resolution to San Rafael. That was how they chose to approach it.
And then also there was some mention of the sales tax exceeding what was originally projected in 2004. I know that our sales tax is greater than what we had anticipated, Measure F and Measure C. So has TAM also experienced that phenomena?
Yes, we've collected more sales tax than we collected in 2004.
But may I specify, this was all laid out in the expenditure plan. Council Member Eklund, I think you'll recall, you served on TAM, and there were projections made, and we are tracking with those projections.
Right, I'm just I'm just having the experts validate the speaker's representation. So I don't have any other questions.
Okay, Council Member Lubin.
TAM also received a lot less sales tax in 2008-2009 than had been projected. Two questions. There's been a lot of talk about San Rafael tonight. I'm hesitant to ask this question because tonight we're making a decision what we think is in the best interest for Nevada. A lot of comparisons have been made. San Rafael is a different city. They're at 9%, we're at 8.5%, but just for the record, can you clarify exactly what vote San Rafael took and whether or not they voted it down or they decided to table it indefinitely, or what was the vote?
Thank you for the question. The recommendation by Council Member
Nicola? Bushy? Phillips? That's all of them.
Nicola. Was to take no action. Roll was called, and it was voted 4-1 to take no action. I was at the meeting.
Okay. Great. And then my second question was, I know the projector's off, but going back to the presentation a little bit, we don't have to pull it up. A big part of Measure A is the major arterials throughout the cities, of which there were 5 project areas. Nevada's project area is Nevada Boulevard. That project has not no ground has been broken yet. Other cities have seen ground broken on their major project. Can you just talk a little bit about that? I mean, that's a $12, $13, $14 million allocation there. I think our residents haven't seen that yet. Other cities have seen it. Maybe just talk about that a little bit more to clarify what is coming in the way of a major roadway improvement for Novato.
Yes, I'd be glad to answer that. We have five planning areas that were defined within the 24-page expenditure plan that was approved by voters in 2004. There has been ground broken on the Central Marin project, 4th Street West End, that project was completed. The Southern Marin project in Miller Avenue is under construction presently. The Ross Valley project that is Sir Francis Drake from 101 to the town of Ross limit. They've started to develop that project, but it hasn't gone under construction. The West Marin project, which was Sir Francis Drake through Samuel P. Taylor Park, has been constructed and completed. And the Novato Boulevard project, and I'm going to turn to Russ to answer any details on this, is in the development stages as well. So two of our five areas have projects in development. Three of the five, the projects have broken ground.
But just at the high level for the Novato residents that are watching, there is roughly $14 million right. set aside, ready to go into this project. You don't need to go and find the funds. It's there. It's right. allocated, dedicated for major improvements right here in Novato.
That's correct.
Great. Thank you.
I guess my question is, could you go through, because I appreciate Mayor Pro Tem Friday's trying to clarify exactly what we're doing, and thank you, Jeff, for answering those questions. If we go with this and it goes into a public forum and starts the conversation with the communities, what does that look like? What does this, you know, how would you choose the stakeholders? Is it going to be representative? And it's sort of a two-part question. Is it representative of all the cities? And is this just a few cities that are going to be voting on this, or is it every city in Marin that you're going to get information for McGuire?
There's a couple questions there.
Right.
So help me if I miss one. We're going to all the cities in Marin to seek support for this initial step of raising the sales tax cap to provide the headroom. What's delineated in your memo in the request portion. That's exactly what we're doing in every city in Marin. What was your other questions?
What does the stakeholder, when it goes to the process, what goes through the process if we get that far? What does that look like? Because I think the public needs to understand that this isn't anything here. We're not doing anything here other than possibly giving permission or supporting a conversation. And letting Senator McGuire be able to go to Sacramento and request an exemption on the existing cap in order for that conversation to occur. So what does the program or process, what do you think it would look like in terms of involving the public, engaging them, and having them have a say in whether or not this would eventually go to a ballot? Or does this automatically mean that this is going to a ballot with a tax and there's no conversation or possibility of it not going anywhere?
The staff recommendation will be in the April-May timeframe to seek approval from the TAM board and input on the formation of a very broad-based expenditure plan advisory committee. That committee will hold public meetings for up to, I'd say, 8 to 10 months. Probably on a monthly basis. It could be more than once a month. That committee will have both geographical representation as well as special interest representation, and may also include local, let's say, lead staff representatives from the Marin Public Works Association or from the Marin Managers Association. We also hope to involve our Citizens Advisory Committee that has been operating for 12 years, overseeing the work of TAM and managing their own independent audit annually
They just produced an audit report recently, and that's available on the town website. If anyone's interested, those have been done for 12 years. The Citizens Advisory Committee has the same kind of makeup of special interest, geographical, and you know, we've included members in the past expenditure planning committee efforts from the environmental community, the business community, the Taxpayers Association representative, as well as others. As being in our one of our largest cities, we would seek a representative from your community. As, and that can include someone that is recommended by our county commissioner or a member of the business community, as well as any special interests. So we put together a committee for our $10 vehicle registration fee in 2010. It had about 22, 24 members, and we met over a six-month period. We would do something similar here. It means we'll all be noticed and open to the public.
Okay. I'm going to go to council one more time. Is there anybody who has any additional questions before I ask her?
In the next steps portion in the staff report, it said to receive statements of support from each jurisdiction in Marin for TAM to seek legislation to remove a procedural obstacle and begin a thorough community conversation about whether to pursue a new sales tax measure dedicated to transportation purposes in Marin. But yet, in that same section on next steps, you said that you would be working with Senator McGuire to introduce that legislation by the third week of February at the latest. So it doesn't sound like you're really going to be seeking a lot of public engagement, given that there would be less than a month to have a thorough community conversation about whether to pursue a new sales tax measure dedicated to transportation purposes. So help me to understand why it isn't backwards or the other way around. I mean, it's, you want to have that community conversation first.
Yes,
in my opinion, but.
Yes, there are two separate processes. The legislative process is a two-year process. As you know, this is the very beginning of the two-year legislative season. And it could well take into the second year to gain the approvals needed. So that is a long fuse process.
Thank you.
I would like to make a motion that we would support this legislation. I think maybe the appropriate. Oh, I'm sorry, I thought we were done with questions. I apologize.
You finished with your questions and you finished with yours.
No, so Pam, do you have questions?
Yeah, I wanted to make
If you could speak into the microphone.
I wanted to make a motion to indefinitely.
Is that a question or a motion? I was in the middle of making a motion and you interrupted me to make a question.
I said I'm going around for one more round. Yeah, raise your hand. I looked to my right and my left. If you have a question, I'm happy to do that.
She raised her hand to be recognized, not necessarily to ask the question.
I was in the middle of making a motion, so I'd like to finish making my motion. And okay, I would like to make a motion that we would support this legislation. I think the way if you do it, we can discuss how we want to do it. But to direct staff to write a letter, which would be signed by our mayor.
I'll second.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded.
I have comments.
I was going to ask for is there any discussion? So with that,
do you want to do comments before the vote or after the vote? Doesn't matter to me.
Yeah, it's fine with me. It's the discretion of the council. What would you like to do? Comments before?
After the vote.
You want after the vote? Okay. That was that. All right. So if you could call roll.
Councilmember Drew?
No, definitely no.
Councilmember Ivan?
No.
Councilmember Lucan?
Aye.
Mayor Pro Tem Friday?
Aye.
Mayor Atkins?
Aye. And now we're going to go to comment. public to issue the motion first?
Well, I really want to thank everybody for being out here at the late hour. I know that for some it wasn't the result that you were looking for, but I thank you for being here and being involved in the process. I want to be very clear, this is just the very beginning of the process. And it will allow us to have a discussion. Could we have a discussion without this tonight? Absolutely. The result of that discussion, though, if it were in favor of an additional tax, it might be too late at that point. So I do think there is a chronological order that we need to follow with this. I want to keep my comments very short because it is the late hour. During comments, I did hear the phrase incessant taxation. A year ago, sales tax in Nevada was 9%. Currently, it's 8.5%. If we had asked many of the individuals that are stuck in gridlock, stuck in congestion, whether it be on 101 or school traffic, a year ago, if they'd be willing to decrease their tax to, say, 8.75% and put some of that money towards transportation, I think there'd be some interest. And that's a conversation I look forward to having in this community, to seeing, are there improvements that can be made? What might those improvements cost? Is it something that we can address or solve through an additional sales tax measure? And if so, is there even appetite in the community to raise the sales tax? Those are all things that will happen a part of this process. So I think we need to follow this chronological order so that we can have the door open in case that is the will and the desire of our community.
Thank you. And I'm going to go to Council Member Drew.
I take any discussion or consideration of tax increases very, very seriously. And the consequences of that for myself, for people in Novato, for the entire county. I'm supporting this motion because I believe in local control, and I believe that the people of Novato and the people of Marin should be able to have a say in how we want to tackle our transportation challenges.
Thank you very much. Councilmember Drew.
I think tonight is a watershed moment. You can see what the three members who voted for this are saying to you. They are saying, we are going to support this despite camouflage, despite the fact that the titling didn't even enable the population to know what was being discussed. They said it at 11:30, whenever normal people are in their beds. They said it despite all the testimony to the contrary. So frankly, we could have done this starting at 10 of 10. We could have had the vote, and the vote would have had the same outcome. And whether you're saying it was an opportunity to make an opportunity, or whether you're saying it's a way to remove a procedural obstacle, or whether you're saying it's a way to close the closet door, doesn't really matter. This is setting the stage, setting up, taking the first step for raising taxes. And that's simply the bottom line. That's it. So if you call it a cow instead of a tax, it's still going to be a tax when McGuire asks for it. So maybe we will be saved by Santa Fe. We certainly will not be saved by the majority in the bottom.
Thank you. If you could please not do that, it's not respectful because it's not allowed in our council chambers. But I appreciate you being here. Just please be respectful of everyone's opinion here.
Opinion is that you guys may...
Excuse me, public comment is done. Council Member Eklund.
Thank you very much, Mayor. I did not support the motion because I believe that there should have been a thorough community conversation first about whether or not the sales tax cap should be raised. Secondly, there should have been a thorough community conversation about an expenditure plan. What would the funds be used for if it stayed at its current rate, or if there was a new sales tax measure that was put at an increased rate? I don't feel as though this process has been open and transparent at all. Not only with the title, the subject matter, but with this, the way it's been presented tonight. I called our assistant city attorney this afternoon to find out whether or not the subject description complied with the Brown Act. According to the Brown Act, you look at the subject description as well as what is on the agenda, including the request. So combining those two statements, it's clear. But not a lot of people in the community will go beyond the subject matter. So when you look at the subject matter, it is not transparent. And I'm very disappointed, not only in the way the Transportation Authority has presented this subject, but also I'm disappointed that our city staff didn't question or didn't change the way the subject was presented. Consideration of support for the Transportation Authority Marin and their effort to remove a state procedural obstacle to allow community conversation and maximum flexibility for local jurisdictions. That what we talked about tonight is not going to do that. Nothing is preventing that community conversation, in my opinion. There is no chronological order that has us seeking state legislation first and then having a community conversation. It really should be the other way around. We work for the community, we work for the residents of our community. And I think that if this...
If you could wrap up, please.
Excuse me, our administrative manual does not have a limit of 3 minutes. And this is a very important discussion, Mayor Athas. And in order to explain my no vote, I may need just a little bit more time.
Excuse me.
But I happened to attend the Transportation Authority Marin on December 1st. When this item was brought,
you could weigh in,
was brought before the Transportation Authority.
Has the council adopted a 3 minute rule in terms of the comments made by council members in support or opposition to the motion?
No.
The way, when we had our meeting, we discussed this, and when I was mayor before, I had implemented a 3 minute comment period to be fair to the public. As the public, we give them 3 minutes and hold them to that. And I've always run the meetings the same way, and had said that when I started handing over as mayor, that's what I would be doing, that we are having 3 minute comment. If it's good enough for our public, it should be good enough for us.
And ultimately, the way that the council meeting runs its proceedings is up to the council, and the mayors can provide guidance and impose rules that the mayor thinks is appropriate, but if the majority of the council disagrees, then the mayor's ideas can be overruled. The lesser's policy that has been adopted previous to the meeting itself.
So if I may finish, which is not very much further.
Well, then wait a minute. The mayor has imposed a rule that has been followed by the council since she took over.
Not without objection.
Well, then it's up to the council to decide who's going to control the meeting and whether the rules that the mayor would like to see followed or be followed or not. So it's individual council members don't have a say-so as to how the proceedings are to occur. It's up to the majority of the council to decide that.
And the council, if I might add, at the beginning of the meeting, stated that they couldn't see the time clock. You now have time clocks in front of you, and you have been honoring them. The rest of the council did as well. But I will defer to you and give you.
And I think that this is an item that needs to be put on the council agenda, and I'll exercise that in February. So if I will just finish, and I could have been finished long before this, if you had let me continue. I attended that December 1st Transportation Authority meeting, and I was really shocked by the lack of discussion and debate that the commission members had. I did appreciate Councilmember Lucan's question about if an extension or a cap was released, is it possible for cities to take advantage of that? And the answer was no. The bottom line, I think that this is being done in the wrong manner, and I believe you're doing it in the wrong way. You should first get the community engaged in this debate about raising the sales tax rate first.
Thank you. You can put the 3 minutes on me, please. Council is not the deciding voice in a ballot measure, whether there's an increase or a decrease. Our city attorney mentioned that ultimately it's the people. I actually didn't make up my mind prior to coming here. I wanted to listen to the people, which I did, but I also listened to the presentation, which I felt was well done and very clear. I feel that what we're doing is not talking about the tax. The tax talk will come later. What we're talking about is giving the legislative need that we need to have in order to have that conversation about whether or not it wouldn't impose upon the local control portion of the tax, but would exceed it, only because it would be above and beyond. And in order to have that discussion regarding going above the red line, we need to have that on the legislature act on that. I feel that what our community has asked for repeatedly is to be involved in public engagement, to have transparency, to be involved, and I feel that this is what this is doing. We haven't had the conversation yet. The plan hasn't been implemented yet because the plan's gonna involve the public and stakeholders, and it's gonna be, as what Diane and Stephanie have said, it's gonna involve a different group of people who are gonna put it together, and maybe that group will ultimately decide not to put it on a ballot. So I feel that the conversation, the reason we didn't have it tonight, and the reason why I'm supporting this motion, is to give the public an opportunity to be involved in this process. And if you feel, after being involved and coming to the myriad of meetings, which it sounds like there's going to be available to do, with proper notice, and I'm sure the city will be very involved in making sure that this is noticed correctly so that people are aware of it by all the different forms that we can go out there and do to make sure people can get involved. So I feel this is what the public's been asking for. I want to give you the opportunity to be involved in this discussion. And then if you decide that it is inappropriate to have a tax, state your voice. And ultimately, if you do, it's your decision. There's a two-thirds vote of the people that would decide whether or not this tax takes place. So I feel that I'm doing what the public has been asking us to do, to get involved in a transparent process and get the public involved.